A big moment for biology students is learning how cells divide. I still remember the hours I spent in high school and college poring over my color-coded notes, trying to remember the intricacies of this process. There are two general flavors of cell division, mitosis and meiosis, and today we'll be focusing on meiosis. When a cell undergoes meiosis, the resulting cells wind up with half the amount of DNA as the original cell before the division. Whereas when a cell undergoes mitosis, the resulting cells wind up with the same amount of DNA as the original cell. That was obviously a super simplified explanation. In class, you'll spend a lot of time learning all of the details and what's going on at the molecular level, but this video isn't about that. Today, we'll be learning a lab technique that will allow us to visualize meiosis happening in flower anthers. Yeah, we're gonna see it with our eyes. What? That being said, you should be familiar with the phases of meiosis before doing this lab exercise. So if you'd like a quick refresher, head on over to the description of this video where you can find a bunch of links to resources that can help you out. All right, let's get started with our experiment. You will need a vial of farmer's fixative, AKA one part glacial acetic acid, three parts ethanol, some dissection tools like forceps and scalpels, a dish of tap water, 2% acetocarmine stain and a pipette, microscope slides and cover slips, a blunt object like the bottom of this test tube, a light microscope, and flower buds. I'm using onion flowers because they make these giant heads that contain flower buds at lots of different developmental stages, which is ideal if we want to see the different stages of meiosis. First, we need to put our flowers in the farmer's fixative overnight to preserve their DNA. These are my onion heads after a night in fixative. Let's take one out and put it on a microscope slide to dissect it. As I peel away the sheath, you can see lots of little flower buds at different stages. I'll pluck a few off and let them sit for a couple minutes in the tap water to rinse away the fixative. Notice how tiny these buds are. Meiosis happens way before a flower opens, so it might take some troubleshooting to figure out the right stage. Meiosis happens in flower anthers and ovaries to produce cells that will eventually become pollen and part of the ovules, respectively. But flowers make way more pollen than ovules, so we have a better chance of finding meiosis-ing cells in the anthers. So next, I'm going to put a drop of acetocarmine stain on a slide, put a flower bud in that, and dissect out the anthers. The acetocarmine will stain the cells chromatin red. Next, I'll take the bottom of this test tube and gently squish the anthers a couple of times so the meiotic cells inside pop out onto the slide. Then all we have to do is place a cover slip on the slide, add a little more stain to fill in any air pockets, and pop it onto the light microscope. You'll need a pretty high magnification, something like 40x or above. Okay, let's see. Focusing. Ah, here are some meiotic cells! Oh my gosh, okay, this is definitely telophase 2 because I'm seeing 4 nuclei here, so everything's already split up. This looks like metaphase 1. I can see all the chromosomes lining up at the center of this cell. Oh my gosh. It's one thing to memorize your notes, but another thing to see this for yourself. Wow. Ah, this is so cool! Look at those chromosomes go! Remember, this protocol is a little finicky. Sometimes you can over-squish the anthers and cause your cells to break. Sometimes you'll have to look at a bunch of different flowers to get all of the phases of meiosis. It took me a bunch of tries to get it the first time, so don't be discouraged if you don't get it right away. I'm not going to show you all of the phases of meiosis today because I want you to explore and apply what you've already learned about meiosis in class to identifying the phases in your own experiment. So go have fun trying to find them all and see what those chromosomes are up to.